Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I received pocket size mini oscilloscope DS211. It have 200 kHz bandwidth, 1 mega sample rate, 1 channel and 1 wave out. So it is 1 channel 200 kHz oscilloscope. It is provided from Miniware to review it. So let's see its features and how we can use it. Let's start. Let's unbox it. It have operator manual in Chinese language and English language user manual. Here are functions and parameters. Analog bandwidth up to 200 kHz, 1 mega sample per second. Maximum sample memory depth 8K. Horizontal sensitivity, and it have inbuilt signal generator from 10 Hz to 1 MHz. We can say it is 2-in-1. It is oscilloscope and it have inbuilt signal generator. Weight 66 gram and USB power cable. Operating conditions, and here are different displays, connectors and different menus. How we can select functions. Every function is explained nicely. Let's see it. And here is a warranty card. And quick to use. Safety instructions. Here is a display, LCD display, function buttons and menu buttons, different settings. Three connectors are here, input, and it is MCX connector. It is not a BMC, MCX connector. Here is signal generator output, USB power cable for charging and firmware update. Here is power button. Digital storage oscilloscope. Warning, input plus minus 40 volt maximum. So peak to peak 40 volt. Let's check out more. Here is tray. And then we can see USB cable. Grounding clip. Wow, 1x 10x probe. So that means if it is 1x, at 1x we can measure 40 volt, at 10x we can measure up to 400 volts. Wonderful. And tip covers. Now first I will connect it to charger to charge it for first use. After charging I connected this probe and I will remove the screen cover. I plugged in the probe. I will power it up. Software version 1.24. 1.25 version is available on the website, so we can upgrade. We can download and upgrade. And I will place it on my self-made stand. 1x setting to the probe. Signal high to oscilloscope probe input. Ground with the ground, return with the return. I will turn on the function generator. And we will apply some signal to measure on the oscilloscope. Here is battery voltage per division. It is blinking. That means we are in volt per division setting. And here is selected menu is selected from here YN. That means if we will set this button, so we will change this setting. YN, that means vertical setting, 5 volt. We can see the signal amplitude is now decreasing. Right side amplitude will decrease 5 volt per division. To enter in Y axis submenu, press M, then scroll down, coupling. Here is AC coupling. If you will select right side, DC coupling. AC coupling, we can toggle between AC and DC. Then the probe attenuation. This time it is not showing any probe value, but if I will change to 10x, the figure 10 will displayed on the screen corner. Now we are in 1 axis, so 1x probe is okay. Then Y offset, if there is any offset, so it will indicate the offset value, but we are not providing any offset, so it is blinking at 0 here. That's good. Then for cursors, cursor 1, cursor 2, we can set the cursor any to measure any signal, and we can set cursor V2 up or down, and we can hide or display the cursors. Then ranges, okay. Now in x-axis, that is time setting. Enter in the menu. This time the yellow function is selected and yellow range is blinking, flashing. M, that means time base. If I will select to right side, 50 microsecond, 0.1 millisecond, 0.2 millisecond, and we can see the signal is now collapsing. This time I am using 1 kilohertz. Okay, if I will set to 100 hertz, the signal is now enlarged. We can change the time base to adjust the signal within this screen. In submenu, we have view position, then sample depth. Sample depth, that is the refresh rate. If you will select the lower value, that will much better. Sample depth, we will select to 1K, that's good. So it will not be loaded. Then we have cursors, the vertical cursors to measure any signal. Cursor T2, time 2, time 1. Hide the cursors. Now cursors are hidden. Then we have trigger menu here. Sync mode, trig mode, positive edge triggering, negative edge triggering, then auto fit, then threshold, sensitivity. How sensitive we want to make a trigger. Now I am setting for 400 millivolt, then hide trigger. If you will show it here, the trigger is visible now, at which point it will trigger the display. If we will show it, so green line, it will indicate that this is the trigger. Next is measurement. In some menu, we can select frequency. Frequency is already visible here. Then duty, duty cycle. Then we can select voltage, average voltage, peak to peak voltage, V max, V minimum, frequency, duty cycle. Okay, duty cycle, it is by default. Then here is EX, examination or comparing some values, external reference, external position, external height. Then there is FN menu. In this menu, we can save this wave shape as a BMP, as a DAT, as a buffer, CSV, SVG. We can load the DAT file or we can load buffer file. Okay, we can save as a BMP. It is saving as save.002.bmp, so we can download using USB. Then there is signal generator. This menu, when we will use this menu, it will give output from the second port. So we can take output and we will see on the oscilloscope. Output type, output frequency, output duty cycle. Then there is some settings. What is that? Backlight. If you want to set backlight, we can increase the LCD backlight. You can see now it is bright. If I will press the left side, so it is dim. Then there is auto calibration button. When we will press auto cal, we will remove the signal, waiting for the calibration. Complete calibration. Save calibration parameters. Yes. Press run button for yes. M for no. Yes. It is now calibrated. Self calibrated. That is excellent function. Okay, now restore factory setting. Then there is standby time for inactivity 10 minutes. And then there is power off 20 minutes. After 20 minutes it will turn off. If there is no activity, it will turn off. Now I will change the wave shape. Yes, it is responding nicely. 100 Hertz, and it is 100 Hertz. I will put 1 kilohertz. Yes, it is showing 999 1 kilohertz. And now we will change the time base. Now I will set frequency to 50 kilohertz. And I will set time base, decrease time base to adjust the signal. It is showing 49.950 kilohertz. Good. 100 kilohertz. Yes, that's good. It is showing 100 kilohertz. Now I will change the wave shape. Yes, wave shape is here now. Here we have triangular wave, sine wave, 150 kilohertz. Yes, it is showing 150 kilohertz. Good. Square wave, triangular wave, sine wave, 200 kilohertz. Yes, it is showing 200 kilohertz. It is responding to the signals. And if I will set it to 10x, what will happen? Wow, that's nice. It reduced the signal size. And now if I will set to y axis and prob attenuation, yes, now it is showing 50 volt. So we can measure 400 volt peak to peak using 10x attenuation. I think we should not try to measure with high voltage. Either it have a facility to attenuate the signal, but for CFT it is best to use for limited amplitude. That will be much better. Okay, now attenuation to 1x, 50 Hertz, time base, yes, that's good. So it is showing 50 Hertz. So let's check the signal output of this oscilloscope. Let's check its function generator. For that purpose, I will turn on my oscilloscope. To use its signal generator, we need MCX connector, that is this type, male to female BNC connector, like that. So that is the converter. So we will take signal output from here, but now for test purpose I will connect both probes to 1x. And signal to signal. On the oscilloscope I will set to auto set. Wonderful. It is producing 10 kilohertz. Go to the signal generator menu, output type, sine wave, triangular wave, sawtooth wave, square wave, 10 kilohertz. Now output frequency, 20 kilohertz, 50 kilohertz, 100 kilohertz, 192, 500 kilohertz, 1 megahertz. Wonderful. It is really an excellent addition in this small oscilloscope. 100 hertz, 20 hertz, 10 hertz. Wow, that's excellent. 10 hertz, 50, 100, 1 kilohertz here frequency, 1 kilohertz. Excellent. Duty cycle. Okay, let's monitor the duty cycle function here. 50%, 30%, 10%, minimum 10%, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60%, 70%, 80%, 90%. It's really excellent. I loved it. So we can use as a pocket size signal generator and pocket size oscilloscope for our small projects. I think it is an excellent addition to our projects instead of bench function generator and bench oscilloscope. So it is a pocket size. I am using the same probe for injecting signal. Just only we need to take care that when we are measuring the signal, we will connect to input probe. And if we will connect to this probe by mistake at output point, we will damage it. I think there must be a safety, built-in safety. So here it is measuring, and when we will this connector, it will give output. I will add the links of this product if you want to check the Miniware website from the manufacturer, and you can find the sources. I will give the links in the video description. I hope this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.